funny. We kind of kept waiting and waiting, like trying to set up this dream and see what was going to actually happen. And then we got some great news from the Dream Factory that there happened to be a couple children out of New York, Zoe and Cole, who had cystic fibrosis. And they'd always dreamed to meet Bethany Hamilton. So it was kind of this perfect merging of they've always dreamed to meet Bethany Hamilton. Emily's wanted to learn how to surf. So why don't we all go and why don't we all share that experience?
I think the coolest thing was when I heard her say,
I never thought I could get my dream.
There she is.
She's adorable.
She's really cute, you guys.
Emily, I'm Devin.
Hi.
It's so nice to finally meet you.
Holly, nice to meet you.
Hi. Oh, nice to see you again.
As I was kind of explaining to Gil, is you know, one of our main goals while we're down there is just to be your adventure concierge, if you will. So we just want to make it as fun and as, you know, memorable as possible, and just making sure it's as special as you guys want it to be.
This is gonna be fun.
Six, 10 in the morning.
That's where you're staying. It's very beautiful.
All right.
Cheers.
Mahalo. Yeah.
About halfway through the hike, we're all going through and our eyes just light up because we look over and there's this big rope swing.
Right here, this is the funnest one.
And we're like, oh, that would be so much fun. And then the guide, sure enough, asks, you know, anyone want to go? And so, of course, Molly and Dave and myself are, you know, jumping at the bit.
Are you doing it?
Yeah. And you just want to kind of reach up nice and high and go for it.
There's about 15 of us in the group, and I think we're the only ones at first that wanted to do it. Everyone else kind of has that look of tentativeness in their face, and sure enough, Emily's like, I want to go. So she goes, and bam.
Wow.
Did not quite go the way we were all hoping. She gets right up, brushes her shoulders off, and has a big grin, and she's like, hey, well, that one didn't work out so well. Can I try again? And everyone was just like, wow. She gets ready for the next one, and not so much.
Oh, shoot.
Again, to Emily's credit, she didn't get upset. She just brushed her shoulders off and said, well, I guess it's not meant for me. Once she did that, everyone else in the group wanted to go. To not only fail once in front of a group, but to fail twice and to still get up with a positive attitude, I mean, that really says a lot, and the fact that she inspired others. Ziplining was something Emily really wanted to do. Of course, when we asked Emily, well, what kind of zipline are you looking for? She said, big and crazy. So we found the biggest and craziest zipline. When we got there, it was where they filmed Jurassic Park. So that was really cool for all of us to see and kind of bring back the old memories of watching the movie and then realize, wow, we're going to be ziplining over 1,000-foot canyons and ravines. And, you know, just another opportunity for Emily to, you know, face some fears of heights and everything else. And she was just a rock star. She couldn't get enough of it. And again, Emily took the trip head on, I mean, without any fear, without any hesitation. I would say ziplining might have been, you know, one of those, the best bonding experiences we all had, just because you realize you all did something that scared you and you all succeeded at it. And having someone like Emily on there just only enhanced that. You know, watching everyone, you know, nervous with the heights and everything else and just the scenery and the group. It was a really great trip. We had a lot of fun ziplining. Everyone had been waiting all week to meet Bethany. Zoe and Cole and the family from New York, along with Emily and ourselves, and so this was kind of it. but she flew in all the way from her busy schedule just to make this happen. She's all walking towards us, and there's this silence of, wow, it's really Bethany Hamilton, and almost starstruck with all the fame. And I mean, in Kauai, she can't go anywhere without being mobbed. But you could just tell she was so down to earth and laid back and equally as nervous as Emily was. She really wanted to make this special for Emily. It was really cool to see also, not just Bethany, but how hospitable the family was, how humble and how nice they were to us. So that was really cool to not only get to meet Bethany, but to meet the family as well. Finally, the time we'd all been waiting for, the actual get into the ocean and learn how to surf. Bethany set everything up. You know, she said, I'm flattered that you want me to teach Emily, Cole, and Zoe how to surf, but I don't know the first thing about teaching. I just know how to surf. To our surprise, she went ahead and got her surfing coach, Russell Simmons, one of the most renowned surfing coaches in the world, teaching people from Andy Irons to Kelly Slater to you name it, and we're getting lessons from the best in the world. Bethany had that foresight to make it all about Emily and Zoe and Cole learning how to surf, to where she would ask her coach to come help so she could just be in the water helping. Zoe and Cole, 9 and 11, and unfortunately, you know, battling cystic fibrosis, we had a feeling that once they got on those surfboards, they were gonna pick it up pretty quickly. And sure enough, they hop right up every time. I mean, just made it look easy. But with Emily, you know, she's obviously battling some different types of disabilities. So it was clearly more difficult for her than it was for Zoe and Cole. She kept trying, just wasn't gonna quit and hasn't quite caught in that wave yet, but she's out there again, just trying, and then it happened. You could just feel the energy. There's something in the air. It's almost like slow motion. Bethany pushes her out. She jumps up, gets on her board, and she had done it. She had caught in a wave. And the fact that Emily was able to do all this with just one day of training, one day of coaching, and she was catching a wave is one more example of courage.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. But if you never try, you'll never know. Just watch your world. Lights will guide you home and ignite you.
Oh, there's no way that would ever happen, and she's such a celebrity. I was like, well, you never know. I mean, it's her dream. You know, yeah. Dreams, anything can happen.
She almost seemed like lacking self-confidence to get out there and actually do it, but she just pushed it aside and anyway, stoked me up.
Whatever she puts her mind to, she was to death.
And it's really cool to see her just get really excited and go do stuff and try new things. It's really inspiring.
My favorite day in Hawaii had to have been the day we went kayaking and hiking. This was the first opportunity Emily and I really got to spend some one-on-one time together.
That was terrible. One more.
You're so terrible.
It was really awesome to just kind of be here and just watch it all go down.
She truly has more courage than anyone I have ever met. Yay!
The zip lining was incredible.
I think this is really going to be inspirational and change her life.
I'd love to provide this for somebody else. Make them feel as special as we did this week.
And how was it meeting Bethany?
It was amazing.
One, two, three.
Emily was so excited every day. What was going to happen next?
It's not goodbye, it's we'll see you when we get back home.